Okay, I'm back. Pay attention. Hi, I'm Joe Alton, MD, also known as Dr. Bones of the survival medicine website doomandbloom.net, where you'll find over 1,200 articles, podcasts, and videos on medical preparedness, plus the co-author of the upcoming fourth edition of the Survival Medicine Handbook. We've talked a lot on this channel about face masks, how to properly fit, place, and remove them, but we haven't talked much about gloves. You'll be using gloves a lot more often than masks when performing routine tasks as a family medic, so you should know a little bit about them. The first disposable medical gloves were made from rubber and were introduced around the year 1890 by Dr. William Stuart Halsted, first chief of surgery at Johns Hopkins Hospital. Now, most gloves used in the medical field are made from latex, nitrile, or vinyl. Let's talk about latex. Latex gloves are made of natural rubber and are thought to have the highest level of comfort and flexibility. They provide good defense against bacteria and viruses, and many surgeons prefer them because of their sensitivity. Then there's nitrile. A lot of these gloves here are nitrile. Nitrile gloves are made of synthetic materials and provide excellent protection against viruses and chemical exposure. They're stretchy, durable, and puncture resistant. Nitrile is the best option for those with latex allergies or who may have patients with latex allergies, an issue becoming more common every year in the United States. Vinyl gloves are made of polyvinyl chloride, and they provide good protection against non-hazardous chemical exposure and are pretty cost-effective. They tend, however, not to fit as well and are less elastic. Polyvinyl chloride, by the way, is different from polyethylene, the gloves that are most commonly used in the food industry. Another glove more recently introduced is synthetic polyisoprene. These gloves exhibit excellent softness, reasonable tensile strength, and very good barrier performance against viruses and bacteria. These properties make synthetic polyisoprene latex gloves an option for medical surgical gloves. Synthetic polyisoprene won't result in allergic reactions in those people sensitive to latex, but they are a little bit more expensive than even nitrile gloves. Gloves are often separated into exam gloves and surgical gloves. Non-sterile exam gloves are used for evaluating patients, performing blood tests, and disinfecting. They usually come in sizes from small to extra, extra large. Surgical gloves, however, they're used for medical procedures and must meet higher quality standards. They come in more precise sizing than regular exam gloves in order to increase the tactile sensitivity while you're working. If you're the medic, it's helpful to know what size fits you. Surgical gloves are often numbered, with the most common sizes ranging from 6 to 8.5. Now, some gloves may have extended wrists, for example, like this one, these here, for, say, delivering a baby or other work that may require deeper protection. Others have textured fingers to give a better grip. These are usually on the digits and on the palms. Tips for choosing gloves are pretty basic. Find one that fits well and is designed for the intended use. Check each glove for any punctures or tears. Once gloves are on, avoid touching anything but the area that's at issue. In most cases, gloves are meant to be used only once and then safely disposed. Reasons to use a fresh pair include between patients or specific tasks, when gloves become dirty or contaminated, when gloves get torn, when gloves have been used for 4 consecutive hours or more, after sneezing, coughing, or touching one's hair or face, don't do that, and during dressing changes, in other words, between removing the old contaminated dressing and placing a new clean one. In normal times, the recommendation is that all exam surgical gloves should be discarded after use. In survival scenarios, however, no fresh supplies are going to exist. That means you're eventually going to end up with no gloves whatsoever. Now, is there a way that medical gloves can be disinfected and reused off the grid? Some controversially suggest that in austere settings where no fresh supply of gloves is forthcoming, a 0.5% chlorine solution may be employed to disinfect them so they may be reused. First, you'll wash the gloves with soap and water to remove visible contamination. This may be best performed while still wearing the gloves. You remove the gloves and then add 1 part 3.5% plain bleach to 6 parts water and soak for 10 minutes in the resulting solution. For stronger disinfection, use a pressure cooker at 15 psi for 20 minutes and allow it to dry in the container. Be aware that this may degrade the gloves in a percentage of cases. Some other equally controversial studies suggest chlorhexidine, Hibiclens, and povidone iodine, betadine, soaps may work, and even suggest some gloves can be disinfected several times. If going from patient to patient, you should wash gloves with soap and water and sanitize them again while still on the hands. If the you-know-what has hit the fan and cleaning and reusing gloves is the only option, always examine each glove carefully after disinfection to determine if there are tears, punctures, or other evidence of deterioration. In any case where contamination is caused by blood or feces, discard the gloves, period. When putting on and removing gloves, make every effort to avoid touching the outside of the glove. Now here's Nurse Amy to show you the proper method of putting on and removing gloves.
Today we're going to discuss how to put non-sterile gloves on, which usually come in a box here, and they can be pulled out singular or double if you want. And also we're going to talk about sterile gloves, which can come in packages where it's not folded up too much and where it is folded up pretty well. So let's start with the non-sterile gloves. You have a couple of pairs. Of course, you would first want to wash your hands, make them nice and clean. After you've washed and dried them and or used hand sanitizer, then you can put your gloves on. It's easiest to hold a little curl of the cuff, place your hand inside, spreading your fingers, making sure that all the fingers are nice and in and that the cuff is all the way extended. Then you can take your other glove, also bend a little cuff there, put your hand in. Again, not touching your skin once you have your gloves on, but using this sort of cuff that I made here and then extending it out so that your hands are fully covered. So that's a great way to put on gloves. To take them off, pinch a piece right around your wrist, pull that off, fold up the old glove inside of the other glove, go underneath this glove, again, not touching the contaminated gloves, pulling that out, making it inside out, and then throwing that away. Okay, now let's do sterile gloves. These come in packages, usually with a little fold at the top that you can unfold and open them up. Here's another pair, also with an easy to open fold at the top. This is a little less folded up inside, therefore it looks longer. And this one's double folded up inside. And you'll see the inner package in just a second. The way to open these up is to start from the top. Don't put your fingers on the inside of the package. Open it up and then drop it onto your sterile field without touching anything. Discard the package. Then without touching anything but the outside of this package and just in the corners, you can unfold this, open it up. Again, we're not touching the gloves directly. You can pull this piece open like a book and then pull this open like a book. Now you notice we have two cuffs. You do not want to touch the outer edge of your glove. You only want to touch the inside of the glove where your hands are going to be. So again, you're going to pick up a cuff, hold it, again, this is the inside of the glove, place your right hand, or whichever, it doesn't matter, you want to start with, inside. Notice I'm not touching the outside of this glove, only the inside. Then just go ahead and let go. Now you can pick up the other glove by the outer part of the glove so that your naked hand only touches the inside. Notice my hand is not touching the sterile glove. Place it inside. Get your fingers in the right places. Now once you've pulled the glove all the way off, you want to let go of that cuff. Now I have sterile gloves on. Anything I touch should be sterile. What I deal with should be sterile. In order to take these off when they are dirty is, again, same thing. Pull the wrist, pull that off, fold up the dirty glove inside the other one, and then without touching the contaminated dirty glove, you're gonna go underneath, fold that inside. Now you're touching the inside of the glove, which should not be contaminated, won't hurt your hands, and then you can throw those away in the garbage. You will then wash your hands thoroughly, use some hand sanitizer. Remember, you're gonna wash before you put the gloves on. in between any glove changes, if you're doing dressing changes, and after you take them off. And that's it.
It should be noted that gloves don't replace proper hand washing. Wash and dry your hands before putting on a pair and whenever you replace them with new ones. This is Joe Alton, MD, that old Dr. Bones, wishing you the best of health in good times or bad. Thanks for watching. Hey, if you believe in our mission to put a medically prepared person in every family, do us a favor and check out our entire line of quality medical kits, individual supplies, and personal protection gear at store.doomandbloom.net. That's store.doomandbloom.net. And don't forget to get a copy of the new fourth edition of the Survival Medicine Handbook. Pre-orders are available at our website right now and starting around August 5th, 2021 at amazon.com.